20 miles per hour. Bundy has been in the team for 5 years before taking a year out in 2023. He's been Brent 2, 7 and the synchro leader before coming back in 2022 to fill in for one of the personnel that was unfortunately taken ill. Coming in from the left, you now see 6 and 7 move either side. The smoke will come on for Big Vixen. Bundy is a former Typhoon pilot. He's also a qualified flying instructor on the Tucano, where he was the Tucano display pilot in 2012. And actually, all the pilots in the Tucano have had to go through now. Former Queen's Day is myself, Red 10, former Tornado GR4 pilot, former qualified flying instructor on the whole team on 2. And of course, the military unit, they are commanded by Officer Commanding Raphael Latwin, Commander Adam Collins. He was my predecessor as Red 10. Former Tornado GR4 pilot, and he also flew the F-111 while on exchange with the Royal Australian Air Force. Reds 8 and now make, 8 and 9 now make themselves rearwards. And in this year, it's no secret to anyone who follows aviation and military history, we celebrated the 80th anniversary of Operation Overlord, which of course was the storming of the Normandy beaches. And we heard Mike talking about the Spitfire taking the first kill on D-Day. And in from the right, to commemorate that event, this is Spitfire. On the right-hand side of Red 1 is Red 2, squad leader Chris McCann. This is his first year in the team, and it's going to be taken directly as an instructor on the Tucano. Once he finished his time as an instructor, he then joined the World Rally 617 Dan Buster Squadron on the GR4, where he actually received an Air Force Cross for service on operations over Afghanistan. His opposite number on the left-hand side is Flight Lieutenant Dustin Wales, known as Dusty, originally from Zimbabwe, former Typhoon pilot, having flown with 11 Squadron, an instructor on 29 Squadron before joining the Test and Evaluation Squadron, 41 Squadron, all based at RAF Coningsfield. Smoke is on Reds 4 and 5 as either side of the centre stem make their way rearwards. And in November last year, it was the 20th anniversary of the final flight of one of the most iconic and famous aircraft in aviation history. As the team roll out, there is no mistaking the shape of the wonderful, majestic and iconic, this is Concorde. Thank you.
Polly, and also please say hello to his Uncle Christopher and his Auntie Jane. We now see red 8 and 9 move their way rearwards, and the team will form two distinctive rows. Coming in from the right, the smoke will come on for the Chevron Roll. Inside those blues, there are 11 individuals who get to fly in the back of our aircraft in between displays when we cannot take the full engineering compliment. They are known as Circus. One individual with me at every display is Circus 10, that's Corporal Dye, all the way over to the right, filming the display for debriefing and safety purposes. And he's also responsible for many of the images and videos you see across social media. Looking front to the left, you'll see the team now with 8 and 9 in the rear. For one of the most popular, if not the most popular show, it's the colourful, the dynamic Tornado! The aboard call is made by Red 9 as Red 8 and 9, red smoke for Red 8, blue smoke for Red 9, rolling around the formation as Red 1 bends the team around the left, changes the colour to fly the Tornado down the line. Red 9 now joining the rest of the formation, and we're coming to the end of the first half. As Red 1 continues to bring them around the left, the smoke will come on. This will be your last opportunity to catch the formation in our world famous Diamond 9. The smoke comes on from the right, the 2024 in Diamond 9, the Red Arrows. As we go into the second half, Red 1 has brought back one of manoeuvres not flown since 2003. Once again, get your cameras ready for the 5-4 split. As we go into the second half, we now split down into smaller sections. Off to the right-hand side, you've got Red 1 through 5. They're now known as Enid, named after Enid Blyton's famous 5. And Red 6, 7, 8 and 9 off to the left, they are now known as Hannah, named after squadron leader Ray Hannah. You saw his Spitfire flying earlier. He's one of the early members of the Red Arrows, the only Red 1 to lead the team for 4 years. He took the team from a 7 to a 9 and also formed our trademark Diamond 9. Enid from the right, Hannah from the left, 4-5-4 cross. From the Black Arrows to give us our name, and then we took the aircraft from the Yellow Jacks. coming in from the right. Enid will now create a shape to represent and pay tribute to that aircraft. This is Nat.
Pull one, pulls it up once
call for Bread 6. Siege aircraft now pull up. Experience 5 to 6 G. That means everything about you has now been 5 to 6 times heavier than what you and I are on the ground. There is a height of over 3,000 feet that will be inverted 6 degrees nose down before they roll the right way up to complete the manoeuvre called Boomerang. Serpent. As the team pass the red one, keeps that next part of the serpent flat, you can see our famous red, white and blue. You may be able to see a small point underneath the bottom of the airplane. That's the smoke point. That smoke point is capable of producing approximately 5 minutes of white smoke, 1 minute of red smoke and 1 minute of blue shake. And each of the colours have its own individual button on the pilot's control column. And they're selected through the display to ensure that we have the right colour at the right time in the display. You now see reds 2, 3, 4 and 5 moved up alongside red 1. They're looking 90 degrees along their shoulders. Extremely hard formation to maintain as the smoke comes on. In the second part of the serpent, the tango present. Drawing in the sky of 60 to celebrate our 60 display season. Keep it alive once again, red 6 and 7. For the final manoeuvre of the show, that clocks at approximately 1,500 feet. They'll make their way back towards the display line for their final pass once again. That's only 100 feet above the airfield. With a closing speed of over 800 miles per hour, looking to pass within only 30 metres of each other.